हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई डॉक्टर सुनेंद्र गुप्ता, प्रोफेसर हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बेरी साइंस, ओरिएंटल कॉलेज ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी. नाउ टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट द इंजीनियरिंग मैथमेटिक्स वन सिलेबस एंड द फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज रोले थ्योरम. नाउ फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज रोले थ्योरम एंड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ द रोले थ्योरम. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल डिस्कस इफ एफ ऑफ एक्स इज अ रियल वैल्यूड फंक्शन ऑफ एक्स सच दैट एफ ऑफ ए इक्वल टू एफ ऑफ बी. नंबर टू, एफ ऑफ एक्स इज कंटिन्यूस फंक्शन द क्लोज इंटरवल ए बी. And this closed interval can be written as a is less than equal to b. And third point, f of x is differentiable in open interval a b, that is a less than x less than b. Then there exists at least one real value of c belongs to open interval a b such that f dash c equal to 0. Now where f dash c is called the derivative of the function at the point c, and this point c belongs to the open interval a b. In this graph, we have seen that the f dash c is equal to 0. It means that this f dash c, that is the slope of the function, which is the parallel to the x-axis. And we, in the second diagram, we have seen that c1 and c2 are the two values which lie from the open interval a, b like. Rolle theorem ensured that there is at least one point on the curve y equal to f of x at which tangent is parallel to the x-axis, abscissa of the point lying between the open interval a, b. There are some important point, this is called the notes. Number one, Rolle theorem fails to hold good for a function which does not satisfy one of the three conditions stated above. There may be more than one point C such that f dash C equal to 0, and the converse of the theorem is not true. That means for some function f of x, f dash C equal to 0, but f of x may not satisfy the condition of Rolle theorem. It means that when the function f of x is defined, which is called the real valued function, and follow the three conditions, then definitely the value of c belong to open interval a b such that f dash c equal to 0. Now we will explain this theorem with the help of the example. Now the first problem is verify the Rolle theorem for the function f of x equal to x cube minus 6x square plus 11x minus 6 in the closed interval a b. Now in this question, the function is polynomial and the interval is finite. Now first of all, the function is f of x equal to x cube minus 6x square plus 11x minus 6. Now the first point, now here a equal to 1 and b equal to 3. That means we first have to find the value of the function at x equal to 1 and the x equal to 3. Now at x equal to 1 and x equal to 3, now putting the x equal to 1 in the equation number 1, then we get f of 1 equal to 1 cube minus 6 1 square plus 11 into 1 minus 6. 6 minus 6 yani ki 12, 12 minus 12 yani ki 0. That means f of 1 equal to 0. Similarly, we find the value of function f of x equal to 3. Now f of 3 equal to 3 cube minus 6 3 square plus 11 into 3 minus 6, which is equal to 27 minus 54 plus 33 minus 6 equal to 0. It means 0. Now I've seen that f of 1 and f of 3 equal to 0, that means the first condition is fulfilled. Now the second condition, f of x is a polynomial function. Since f of x is a polynomial function in x, and we know that every polynomial function is continuous in the closed interval 1, 3. Since f of x is a polynomial function in x, then it can be differentiated very easily. That means f dash x equal to 3x square minus 12x plus 11. Now we suppose our value c belongs to open interval 1, 3 such that f dash c equal to 0, that means 3c square minus 12c plus 11 equal to 0. Now this is a quadratic equation. We can find the value of the c with the help of the formula. The formula is c equal to 12 plus minus b square minus 4ac, 4 into 3 into 11. Now we calculate to this value, that means 144 minus of this subtract, then we get the 12. The value of the 12 can be write the 2 root 3, which is equal to 12 plus minus 3.461 divided by 6. Taking the plus sign, then we get 2.5773, and the taking the minus sign, 1.4226. Now clearly that the both the values of the c belong to the open interval 1, 3. That means the Rolle theorem is verified for the closed interval 1, 3 and the function f of x equal to x cube of this much. Now we discuss about the one more question. Verify Rolle theorem for the function f of x equal to 2x cube plus x square minus 4x minus 2. Now in this question, we have does not define the interval. So how to find the interval by given the function? For this, we taking the f of x equal to 0, be taking the f of x equal to 0 like this. That means 2x cube plus x square minus 4x minus 2 equal to 0. Then we factorize x cube common, x square 2x plus 1, then minus 2, 2x plus 1, then we taking the 2x plus 1 common, then x square minus 2. That means the value of the x equal to minus half, and the second value minus root 2 minus 1.414, and the third value x equal to 1.4144. Now which value is less and which value is greater? Here we seen that minus 0.5 and x equal to minus 1.414, that means the minus 1.4114 is the least value as compared to the 0.5, and the greatest value is a 1.414. Therefore the required interval is minus root 2 to plus root 2. The required interval is minus close interval minus root 2 to plus root 2. Definitely f of minus root 2 and plus f of root 2 both are the zero values like this. That means the first condition is fulfilled. Now second condition is f of x is a polynomial function. That means f of x is continuous in the closed interval a, b. That means a minus root 2 to plus root 2. Third point, since f of x is a polynomial function in x, then it can be differentiated such that c belongs to open interval minus root 2 to plus root 2, which is equal to f dash of x equal to 6x square plus 2x minus 4. That means that therefore exists at least c belongs to open interval minus root 2 to plus root 2 such that f dash c equal to 0. That means 6c square plus 2c minus 4, which is simplified, then with 3c square plus c minus 2, which is can be factorized in this such way 3c in bracket 3c plus 1 minus 2c plus 1 equal to 0. Now taken c plus 1, that means 3c minus 2 equal to 0. Therefore the value of the c is 2 by 3 and minus 1 by 2. Here we see that both the values belong to the open interval minus root 2 to plus root 2. That's therefore the our function f of x satisfied the Rolle's condition. Therefore Rolle condition fulfilled for the given function. Another we discuss about the third question, discuss the applicability of the Rolle theorem for the function f of x equal to x square plus 1 when x lie from 0 to 1 and the 3 minus 1 when x lie from 1 to 2. In this question, we discuss about the how to apply the applicability of the Rolle theorem. It means that in this condition, we see that the 1 is a 0 is a point A and the 2 is a point B. Therefore, we can find the value of the f of A and f of B. That means f of 0 and f of 2. First, clearly the required interval is 0 to 2. Therefore, first we calculate the f of 0. That means the x equal to 0. Now we have seen that x equal to 0. That means we taken the function x square plus 1, that means 0 square plus 1, which is equal to the 1. Similarly, x equal to 2, that means the 3 minus x, yani ki f of 2 equal to 3 minus 2. We have seen that f of 0 and f of 2 both are the equal value. That means the first condition fulfilled. Now we cannot find the value of the second condition. First we discuss about the differentiability of the function. And differentiability of the function, we taking the one of the values from the close interval 0 to 2, definitely we taking the value is 2. Okay, here we taking the value of 2. Yahan 2. Now how? Now right hand derivative f dash 1 equal to 1, which is the limit x tends to 0 f of 1 plus h 1 plus h minus f of 1 upon of h. Now here we how to find the value of f of 1? F of 1 we can calculate from the x square plus 1, either 3 minus x. Both the values are same. Now we are taking the 3 minus x, that means here x square plus 1, the 1 square plus 1 here 3 minus 1, both are the given the values of the 2. Now we are putting the values f of 1 plus h, that means a value which is greater than 1, that means taking the 3 minus of x. So 3 minus 1 plus h minus 2 divided by h. Now 3 minus 1 यानी कि 2 and 2 से 2 cancellation में हमारे पास आ गया, then we get the h minus h upon of h, which is equal to the minus 1. Similarly we can calculate the left hand derivative at the value of 1, that means limit x tend to 0 f of 1 minus h minus f of 1 upon of minus h. Again f of 1 is 2, f of 1 minus h, that means a value of x which is less than of 1, then we taking the x square plus 1. That means 1 minus h ka whole square plus 1 minus 2. अगेन एक्सपांड द 1 माइनस एच का होल स्क्वायर विच इज 1 प्लस एच स्क्वायर माइनस 2h प्लस 1 प्लस 1 2 विच इज कैंसल आउट बाय द 2 देन डिवाइडेड बाय द h विच इज इक्वल टू h स्क्वायर माइनस 2h डिवाइडेड बाय h दैट मींस h माइनस 2 पुटिंग h इक्वल टू 2 h इक्वल टू 0 दैट मींस 0 माइनस 2 एज दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ द माइनस 2 डेफिनेटली राइट हैंड डेरिवेटिव एंड लेफ्ट हैंड डेरिवेटिव बोथ आर एग्जिस्ट बट दे कैन नॉट बी इक्वल दैट मींस The function f of x is not differentiable. Clearly, right hand derivative and left hand derivative of the function exist, but therefore it is not differentiable in open interval 0 to. Hence, the Rolle theorem does not. Rolle theorem is failed. Now here we discuss about the some questions which are given for you. You can solve this question for practice, and definitely if you have any doubt, you may ask the question in the lecture comment box. Thank you for watching my channel, Dr. Sonendra Gupta.